William Archie spends an awful lot of time doing paperwork and stocking supplies. It's all part of a day's work as the lodge manager at Tupelo Salvation Army.
There's a lot of it, but somebody had to do it.
But things haven't always been so orderly for William. 3 years ago, he was working in Tupelo when the jobs dried up and poor choices added to his problems.
I didn't have nowhere to go. Mm-hmm. And then I wind up I was out in the street and everything, ripping and running the streets. Then I got hooked on the alcohol and the drugs, and then it escalated. And then I became all the way homeless. So as for everyday people, they know me as William Archie, but as the homeless people, they know me as Woody.
Woody, okay.
I lived in the woods of East Tupelo.
One day, William says a daytime thunderstorm got his attention.
Next thing you know, it got just pitch black outside. You couldn't see nothing. You couldn't see it. It was in the daytime. And then next thing I know, I heard the bark popping off the trees. I sat back and I just prayed. And I prayed to the Lord, if he get me through this, I won't have to have no problems out of me no more. So I made it through that night after praying and everything. And then I came down into the Salvation Army.
Well, that was 3 years ago. Since then, William has helped out at a number of positions, including kitchen duty. Eventually, the position of lodge manager became open, and William was a natural fit.
I met a lot of interesting people that is homeless. Mm-hmm. You know, it's not what people think, that homeless is the person that you see on TV or in a movie or something that's out there sleeping in a cardboard box. The average homeless that you see now is people that never been homeless, had a job, worked every day, and they lost everything because their jobs are folded up, and they come in now, you know, and they don't know what to do. And then, you know, you talk with them and everything, and you can encourage them.
William's story does not end there. Through the Salvation Army, he came into contact with Habitat for Humanity. He'll soon be moving into this house behind me, built by Habitat and numerous volunteers, including William. They call it Sweat Equity. He encourages people to do what they can to help the homeless, and he wants folks to know that many homeless people have simply hit hard times and are not looking for a handout, but instead, a hand up. In Tupelo, I'm Allie Martin, WCBI News.